That's Concord, and thanks very much for your forbearance. Traffic delays. I'm here, but look, the situation with this is, it was meant to be a debate of an hour and 45, it's now down to 45 minutes. And as per usual, everything is rushed, fumbled, illogical, confusion. Unreal, Minister. You should be named the government of utter and total confusion. And mandatory hotel quarantine. Look, I call for, I'm not going to be a hypocrite, I called for it at the very start when we were locking down our people and we had no one, we allowed our open borders. And I won't be a hypocrite to say I called for it. And I felt we should have. And many people were aghast and couldn't believe it that they had so much restrictions from worship to, you name it, matches, games, work, school and play of any kind. And then with open borders. And I raised it with the Taoiseach on this floor and the Taoiseach and the previous Taoiseach. Now tarnished it. And no, we were good Europeans, we had to do this. And I always quoted Hungary and other countries and Poland how they did it. And we couldn't do it. So then we introduced it late to the day. We hired a tender out then and we got a company to do it. I have had nothing but complaints about it. From the people, young Irish teachers out in Dubai and trying to come home for the summer and they having to quarantine. Some with children and the expense. There's no question at all thought of the cost. First of all, the human cost and the psychological cost and everything else, but the physical cost to the pocket. They can't afford this to stay in hotels. They could quarantine at home just as well. So here we are now extending it again for another, I'm not sure of the date, but it's October, I think. I'm not certain, but I'm totally opposed to that because it's too late. Like closing, like, and if it's a sheep farm, I am. And if you let one sheep out the gap, they'll all go after them and make a bigger gap and you want a good sheepdog to bring him back. You need to get some kind of, you know, look, the confusion this morning again about what's happening regarding the reopening of hospitality. Utter confusion, and it's not fair to the public. There's plenty paid official civil servants and advisors by the dozen you have, and if you can't be in sync, you've Minister Martin saying one thing, Tarnish is saying another thing. It's really a vying for the airwaves, and then of course we have NPHET vying for the airwaves as well. So I'm opposed to this, and I will be opposing it, continuing because it's illogical, it's too little, too late, and it didn't, as I said, if it was done properly at first, we might be in a different place. Good market. Okay.